We had a moment before we went live here in the live studio audience with Brene, and Brene's joined us tonight, so I'm glad we didn't hit the go button exactly. Hey guys, you are watching the John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday live stream. We are glad that you guys are here. We got some songs coming out of left field for you tonight. We're going to do some REO Speedwagon. We're going to do some Conway Twitty. How's that for some diversity? REO Speedwagon, Conway Twitty. We're going to do Toby Keith. What was the other song I was looking for? Oh, Kansas. Toby Keith of Kansas. Is that crazy? We're all over the place. We're going to be singing the Heavenly Opera. My mom was out there in the chat tonight. So thank you guys. Come on in. We're glad that you're all joining us. This show goes all over the state of Indiana. We get together every Monday night. We call it the John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday live stream. That's what we do each and every week. We try to help you make it through your Monday. Hope you've all had a great Monday so far. And we're going to be singing about 8 songs tonight. I shared some of the covers we're going to be doing. We're going to be doing 4 of my songs. We're going to be letting you know where I'm going to be performing this week. We're also going to be telling you about a live stream show that we want you guys to take advantage of Friday night down at Rainwater Studios. And we'll give you all those details. Going to share some show picks from last week's shows like we always do. And as always, we're going to give away some free merch tonight. So jump in the chat. Say hi. Everybody is out there doing that. We're going to come out of the gate with a little REO Speedwagon. I was at an event in Crawfordsville yesterday playing for the Crawfordsville Moose Family Picnic, and I told them, I said, my very first concert was REO Speedwagon. And the very next week I saw Bob Seger. So you know what I had to do? An REO song and Bob Seger. But this is one I didn't play yesterday because I didn't have all the words. But I decided, in honor of the Crawfordsville Moose Family Picnic, we're just going to sing some REO Speedwagon. So here we go.
Right in the storm now.
some REO Speedwagon out there. When I got to playing that song, I thought, how am I going to end this song? I had no idea. So we just ended it right there. How's everybody doing? Hey, it's that time in the show. I'm going to ask you all to do a favor for me. This show goes out all over the country. We even had people check in out of the country last week. We're going to share with you about that. Tell you about who that person was last week. But right now, it's check-in and sharing time. If you guys will do me a favor, let me know exactly what city you're watching in. Now, a lot of you, I had somebody said, I'm in my kitchen. Brene, do you know where in the kitchen is? Do you know what city that is?
I do not.
Yeah, I didn't either. So I didn't put that in there. But if you said I was in the kitchen in Lebanon or in the kitchen in Crawfordsville, I put that in there. So make sure if you're out of state, we'd love to see where you're watching from. And if you're in state, get a little creative with in the kitchen, cooking some dinner in Boswell, Indiana, or Petersburg. But let me know what city you're watching from while you guys are checking in for me and also hitting the like and the love button up there. It looks like we got like 19 likes and loves. Can we get some more, pretty please? Have you liked and loved Brene?
I have.
Thank you, Brenda. We have Brenda with us. I have two bantering partners. That's good. Hey, I'm going to look in the chat while you guys are checking in for me. And you in-state people, make sure, give me a creative check-in. I love the creative check-in. So I'm going to go all the way back to the top. My goodness, you guys are filling the chat. Everybody in this particular chat says hi to each other. But if you're a new person out there, we want you to raise your hand up and say, hey, this is my first John Stevens Jr. show, or I've never jumped in the chat. Say hello. We'd like to make you one of our regular Monday night friends out there. So Pete Arkamo's out there, Mike Westerfield. There's Connie Schultz right there watching on YouTube. Look at her. Hi, Connie and Larry. Good to see you guys out there. Hi, Dawn Brown, Tammy, Tony. Good to see you Friday night at my show, Tammy and Dean. That was good. Ashley and James was with you. Good to see you. Becky Cummins has joined us. We said hi to Brene and Brenda. Of course, Julie is up there with Pete and Mulberry. Bad Betty's in the house. Hey, Bad Betty, I got a nice picture of you and Buzz. We're going to be sharing. Karen McGill, I got some bad news about Saturday. I'll explain that to you later. We will not be in Rochdale this Saturday. Wasn't my fault, but I won't see you. I won't see you. But look at there. Kara's still representing in Rochdale. Thank you, Kara. I appreciate it. I'll let you know, Kara, what's going on with that show here in a bit. And Larry Davis. Let me see out there. Kevin Enders. How you doing, buddy? He says, hi, John. You know, I read each and every one of these comments out there. So thank you guys for taking the time to say hello. I make sure and read them all, acknowledge them all. And if you say hi to me, I'll make sure and say hi back to you. So we appreciate that. Mike Westerfield, and I think I'm getting to Becky Pettit. Becky Pettit, thanks for hitting my virtual tip jar last week. We'll get to that here in a little bit. Jenny Dalton, oh, I love that. Look at what she put. Thank you for making our gloomy Monday better. Yeah, it was kind of gloomy today, wasn't it, Jenny? Thank you for that. David Maxwell, look at that, another YouTuber out there. Thank you, David. Good to see you, buddy. All right, I'm going to get through here really quick. Cindy from Chicago, good to see you. Like I said, Crystal Beck, look, I love this one. I got to put this up. Crystal Beck checking in from my house in Pennsylvania. Glad to have you with us. There's my mama. There's Mindy, Tim Nelson, Chris Smith, Bob Cruz. I think of Rick Ledoon. How you doing, buddy? Hey, there's my buddy Rick. Him and Chris Wolf's going to be doing a live stream show with us on Friday night down in Rainwaters. Thanks for jumping in saying hi, Rick. Y'all go say hi to Rick Ledoon out there. That's great. All right, Bob Vitro. I think that's it. Guys, I know I could keep going because you guys are filling up this chat, but let's get on to the next song, all right? This says Capo on the third fret. Here's a song that I'm going to do on Friday night. I did it last time I was Rainwater. I was talking to my mom early, and those of you know the story that my mama helped me write this song. I'm not going to tell the whole story tonight. I'll tell it on Friday. But she's my co-writer on this. We get a lot of requests for this song at shows. It's the Heavenly Opry. One arm on the steering wheel, one finger on the radio. Punching that dial, trying to find a little solid country go. Missing buds and dogs and chuckles. Drifting down this county back road, man, I feel so lost. All I wanna hear is a good this new hip hop, it's worse than pop. I need some old school yesterday. What's that coming round bend? Zoom and Tucker drinking again. Then there was a huge flash and a bright flash, and the very next thing I know, I was sitting at the Grand Ole Opry next to my grandpa, right there on the very front row. We saw little Jimmy Dickens, Miss Minnie Pearl, Roy Acuff, and Bill Monroe. Sang along to the Wabash Cannonball and on the banks of the Ohio. Hey, we were soaking up the sound of the Carter Sisters, had a chill running up my spine. Turned to see the smile on my grandpa's face, and it was twice the size of mine. It was better than a real dream. We were taken in the M&B Opry. You know, in heaven things ain't quite the same as the way they are down here. Grandpa looked a whole lot younger as his old guitar appeared. He started picking the lead like he used to show me when I was a kid, and I still believe I could be a country star. After two more acts and three more songs, it was intermission time. Porter Wagner thanked WSM and gave a shout out to Martha White. Then the lights went down. No one made a sound. Then there was a huge crash and a bright flash, and I opened my eyes to see. They struck Elvis Presley and Johnny Cash together like two lost friends. They sang blue suede shoes and love me tender. Don't take your guns to town. Folsom prison and jailhouse rocking Sunday morning coming down. It was a combination of a gospel gathering and a rock and roll Saturday night. And my favorite part was the encore when old Hank sang I Saw the Light. It was better than a real dream. We were taken in the Heavenly Opry. Grandpa's guitar began to fade as a bright white light covered up his face. Then there was a huge flash and some loud claps, and I opened my eyes to see. There stood young Doc Johnson and my girl Jenny and a couple of EMTs. I had a knot on my head, a cut on my chin, a little road rash, but I was fine. Saw old man Tucker busting a smile, and it was twice the size of mine. I told him all the story about seeing Grandpa playing his old guitar, riding along with the bands at the Opry, some of my favorite stars. It was better than a real dream. We were taken in the Heavenly Opry. Old man, wish you all could have been with me. We were taken in the Ebony Opry. Oh, thanks to my mama, Janet Stevens, out there. Thanks for helping me write that song, Mom. She gave me the direction, the idea where to go with that. Would have never written that one without her. I saw Brenda. I'm looking up here at my screen and just kind of watching the chat, and I see Brenda over here. She's playing the air hi-hat. She was just... Mm-hmm.
I was a drummer.
You were a drummer?
Yeah, she was a drummer.
Oh, well, no wonder. She was over here hitting the hi-hat. She's playing like eighth notes or something over there. I don't know music, but she was busy on that hi-hat. I interpreted her hi-hat. Hey, guys, I'm going to check the chat one more time. There's VTR. There's VTR, Vicky. We have so many Vickies that I decided instead of saying Vicky Turner Randolph, which I just did. She's VTR. What are you snapping at?
Nothing.
Oh.
I cracked my elbow.
Oh. See, I don't know whether they're trying to get my attention or distract me, and I think it's the latter.
Sorry.
I think it's, no, it's, it's fine. No, she starts going, is she waving at me? No, she's just stretching her elbow. I should have known. Hey, thanks, Rick. I appreciate that. Look forward to hearing you on Friday night. Look forward to hanging out with Rick Ledoon and my buddy Chris Wolf, who's always fun co-writer to write with. At least when we're doing like songs and around, we kind of play off each other. So, Rick, I'm looking forward to jumping in the mix with you this Friday night. We'll tell you all more about that. There's Kathy. Kathy, we missed you Friday. We missed you. We were in Lebanon Friday. We missed you. We missed you. Vicki Turner says she's already shared three times. EJ, how you doing, buddy? Becky Pettit out there, she said, I love this song. Thank you, Becky. I appreciate that. Evening, Kathy. I said hi to you. Thank you, Brene. She said, awesome song. I'm glad you guys enjoyed that. Glad you enjoyed that. So we appreciate you guys doing a good job on the likes and loves up there. Go ahead and make sure you've smashed them good. Make sure you've smashed them good. I do have a song now coming up for Vicky VTR. I'm not going to say the three names because I said that's why I gave her the name, right? So VTR, you know who you are. She wants to hear an old Kansas song. We're kind of getting off the beaten trail a little bit here tonight, aren't we? Brenda, did you like Kansas back in the day?
I did.
Yeah? In here was getting lost in the song. I tell you, that is such a classic song, isn't it? VTR, thank you for requesting that. We're doing some different things out there. Hey guys, it's that time of the show where we recognize last week's virtual tipper. So Julie's going to pull them up there on the screen for you. Last week for our August 7th show, which was my brother Michael Stevens' birthday, Becky Pettit down the street hit me for $10 on her Venmo. Becky, thank you so much for that. Joe Wessling, Joe and Becky from over in Brownsburg area hit me $5 on his Venmo. Very much appreciated. Pete Arcamo, $10 on your Cash App. Thank you so much. And Robert Mellis, all the way out in El Paso, Texas, watching on YouTube, hit his Venmo for $20. We do appreciate when you guys take time to say thank you with a virtual tip. We're going to let him roll through one more time for you guys out there because we appreciate you. Becky, thank you so much. I do appreciate that. She figured out how to use that Venmo. I know a lot of people sometimes they don't know how to use them different apps. And Joe, thank you so much. Joe's hit that Venmo a number of times before. Thank you, Joe and Becky. Pete Arcamo, thank you. And Robert Mellis, all the way out in El Paso, Texas. We appreciate you. Julie, if you'll let them know, we've provided a number of ways for you guys to say thank you out there. You can use your PayPal account, your Venmo. You can go to my Zelle, or go to your Zelle, your Apple Pay, or your Cash App. Or you can go to my website at JohnStevensJrMusic.com. There's a tab there on the virtual tip page. If you would like to say thank you with a virtual tip, all of the ways of you doing that for you to say thank you are listed in the description. And if you guys would like to do it the old-fashioned way, which a number of you have, you can put a check in the mail and mail it to the address. It's going across the screen, but it's also listed in the very top of the description of this video. So when it's over with, you can go back and find all that information up there. Julie, thanks for pulling that through. I appreciate that. This was last week's runner-up. We don't have a vote off this week. We got plenty of requests and plenty of songs to get to, but here's a song I wrote with my buddy, Mr. Stan Webb. Kind of wrote it when my daughter had her driver's permit. Remember those days? Now, did Aunt Brenda, did you have get to experience any of those driver's permit days?
I did, yes.
Yeah, I assume you did live to tell about it. Did you ever doubt if you were going to live to tell about it? Or were your nieces pretty good drivers?
Well, I never got to train them, so. And Carson won't drive with me, so it was my own time that was bad.
I don't know if y'all hearing this or not. I don't know if y'all hearing this or not, but okay. Getting the backstory here from Brenda back there. But hey, let's get on with this song. Let's get on with this song. Reckless and Innocent Again. Driving 2 inches below the wheel, and when she turns the corner, the front tires squeal, cause she's driving my Ford Taurus way too fast. Got the radio turned up real loud, she's fixing her hair while I'm watching out my front windshield, reflecting on my past. I used to be there in her seat, my whole life in front of me, not ever dreaming any day at all could end. Yeah, there's a part of me wishes I was still 16, living recklessly and innocent again. I'm gonna ditch my job, buy myself a home, ride to Sturgis, South Dakota in the spring. Hey, I'm gonna play guitar for some Nashville star. I'm gonna live the fairy tale, dream all my dreams. I'm gonna play truth on dare, I'll even grow long hair. Go every place around the world I've never been. I'm gonna live, I'm gonna learn, I'm gonna crash, I'm gonna burn. Living recklessly and innocent again. You know that she's been down the interstate and every car inside she's blown away. I'm trying my best inside to hide my grin, but there's blue lights flashing up ahead, so I hit the brakes and say, hey dad, will they ever let me drive a car again? But as they wave us right on by, feel the spirit I recognize reminding me of everything I could have been. I'm I'm still alive, gonna show the world, well, there's still time. I'm living recklessly and innocent again. Hey, I'm gonna ditch my job, buy myself a hog, and ride to Sturgis, South Dakota in the spring. I'm gonna play guitar for some Nashville star. I'm gonna live the fairy tale, dream all my dreams. I'm gonna play truth on dare, might even grow long hair, go every place around the world I've never been.
gonna burn, living recklessly and innocent again. I'm gonna live, I'm gonna learn, I'm gonna crash, I'm gonna burn, living recklessly and innocent again. Oh, always makes you wonder, would you like to go back and be 16 again? We've talked about this just about every time I play this song. Part of me would. Part of me would like to go back through a lot of it. I wouldn't want to stay there. I just want to go back and visit for a little bit. What do you think?
For a little bit.
She said like this long. I was thinking maybe a little bit longer. Hey, guys. It's that time of the show. We ask you, I hope you guys do it. Make sure and hit the like and love button up there. And make sure you do that. And then also make sure you have checked in. Let me know where you're watching from. We have people all over the state and all over the country watching this. So make sure and let us know where you're watching. But let's get to our check-ins from last week, all right? We had an international friend check-in. Emmanuel Whale checked in from Nigeria, which is very cool. It's been a minute since we've had some international people check in. We've had some people on vacation check in with us. But Emmanuel, thank you so much. If you're out there again tonight, welcome to the John Stevens Jr. Show, and thank you for checking in last week. We also had a bunch of people check in from out of state last week. So let's run those names for me, Julie. I appreciate it. Our buddy David Holman, he said he was outside under a tree in Rock Springs, Wyoming. Doesn't that just sound peaceful? Mm-hmm. Outside underneath the tree, listening to the Made It Through Monday live stream. Cindy Anderson was listening in Chicago, Illinois. Thank you, Cindy. Ruthie Wessel always checks in from down in Florida. Crystal Beck joined us again this week, but last week she was up in Pennsylvania. Thank you. The Salt Gal in Saltville, Virginia. Thank you. Thank you so much out there. Rhonda Beekle Britt checked in Michigan last week. And Carolyn Camster Galloway from Oshkosh. I thought it was Oshkosh. Was that a typo on my part? I thought I double checked. Is there an Oshkosh and an Oshkosh? Does anybody know in the chat? Google that real quick, would you? Brenna, hey. I thought so too, but I put Oshkosh. Wisconsin. I thought it was Oshkosh. You guys let me know, is there an Oshkosh, or did I put a typo in there? Probably me.
Oshkosh.
I know that, but is there an Oshkosh?
I don't think so.
Oh, operator error. That would be me. It happens. All right. Nope. Not showing up in Mr. Goom. All right. Sorry about that, Carolyn. Carolyn checking in from Oshkosh, Wisconsin. All right, thanks a bunch, Julie. Let's get to those in-state check-ins. If you guys are watching out there, let me know what city. We have a lot of people check in from the South Indiana, but make your check-in kind of unique for me, would you? As they come across, there they are. In my room, on my bed, in Frankfurt. That's descriptive. Lafayette, Indiana. Harrison Steele in Attica. Thank you, Cindy, for checking in with us. Deep in Bow Hench, that's our buddy Rex Parker. Tipton, Indiana. Brownsburg, Indiana. 900 E in Lafayette. That's a nice specific address. Rochdale, Seville, Avon. Lebanon, Indiana. All the way down to Petersburg. There's a Crawfordsville. Listening on the deck. In Chapel Hill. I tell you, there's a lot of people watch outside this time of year on the deck and on the patio. Anderson check in. Tammy and Dean, listening from Lebanon. Sherrod from Seville. See, these people put their names in the chat. Vicky and Mark in Lebanon. Pam and Tony checking in from Lebanon. See, if you guys type it in, I'll add it. DJ and I know that was Mindy, but she put DJ and I watching from the west side of Indy. Settles. Who cooked dinner? I want to know who cooked. Co-producer chair in Mulberry, the living room in New Ross, down the street from the studio. Now, this is Becky Pettit. Down the street from the live studio, Lebanon, watching baseball. And then she watched NASCAR. Ben Hurd in Seville, the couch in the DD live studio, Lebanon, big city near East Side. On the front porch, sitting at my friend's Betty's porch in Colfax. I know who it is, but she didn't put her name on, so we didn't put it up there. VTR. Jasper, Indiana. On my study PC, as usual, in the living room of my apartment. I put Flay. It was flat. Sorry about that, Michael. You did it right. I did it wrong. In the recliner in the Mulberry studio. in front of the Tube in Crawfordsville. So we hope that you guys will take time to check in if you're in the state of Indiana. And we have a lot of people that check in from Crawfordsville, Indianapolis, Brownsburg. So make sure that you give me a specific check-in, and we will get your specific check. If you say, Brene's watching from the DD studio, I'll put your name in there. But if you just say, watching from the DD studio, I'm just going to type in. I'm making more work for myself, aren't I? You know, she's shaking her head. Okay. All right, guys. Well, let's get on. Hey, we got 49 people watching out there. That's pretty good for a Monday night. Hey, tag. Oh, look at that. We just went to 51. Tag somebody. I was going to say, let's get to 50. We already did that. So tag somebody out there that usually is with us, or say hello, or to tag a friend. Share to your group. We appreciate when you check in and when you share out there. So let's see where we're at on the show. We got a song from my buddy Bob Cruz. I told you Bob had fallen and broken his leg, and he was in Jasper 2 weeks ago. Got a message from him, and he got transferred to French Lick. So I told him that while I'm down, I'll be going down Wednesday for a few days. While I'm down, I'll stop by and see him. So I said, Bob, is there a song we can play for you? And he said, play some Conway Twitty. And he wanted to hear Linda on My Mind. So we're going from Riding the Storm Out to Linda on My Mind. That's covering some ground, isn't it? Here you go, Bob. Well, I'm lying here with Linda on my mind. Oh, and next to me, I'll soon to be the one I left behind. Lord, it's killing me to see her crying. She knows I'm lying here beside with Linda on my mind. Well, you know, I once loved her, and I placed no one above her. Oh, I try so hard not to ever let it show. Oh, but it just wasn't in my plans. Linda squeezed my hand the first time I held her close, and she danced with me. She said, I've loved you for a long time, but you're married to a friend of mine, and I'll try so hard not to ever let it show. But my love for you is stronger, and I can't hide it any longer. So I thought I might as well let you know that I'm lying here with Linda on my mind. Oh, and next soon be the one I left behind. And Lord, it's killing me to see her cry again. She knows I'm lying here beside her with Linda on my mind. She knows I'm lying here beside her with Linda on my mind. For Mr. Bob Cruz, all the way watching tonight down in French Lick, Indiana. Bob, thanks for that request out there. Hey, guys, coming up right after this song, we're going to say hi to Pete and Julie. We're going to share some show picks. I'm finally getting that without sounding like Ed Sullivan. I got a really, really big show. Share some show picks. It's hard to say.
Really big shoe.
Really big shoe tonight. And I know why he did that, because it's hard to put all those shoes and shows together at the same time. But we're going to share some picks from last week's shows. And you want to stick around for that. Make sure you know. See if you know somebody that's in our pictures. We try to get a handful of them. We don't always get a bunch of them every night. But, man, Thursday night, it was a wild party in Brownsburg. So we got a bunch of those. Let's see where we're at. We got time. Julie requested this song. Julie wanted to hear if she's going to. I think I deserve a sip. What do you think?
Good.
Brenda?
Sure.
Okay. I got two okays.
Yeah.
Mom? She probably said no. It's just a little. Is it Diet Sprite?
No.
What is it?
Sprite.
Oh.
That's
all right. I didn't have any. That's why I didn't bring it. That's all right. And a little Captain. Just a little Captain. So, but here's a little Tommy Keith for you out there. Should have been a cowboy. I bet you never heard old Marshall Dillon say, Miss Kitty, have you ever thought of running away? Settle it down, won't you marry me? If I ask you twice, beg you pretty please. She'd have said yes in New York minute, never tied a knot cause his heart wasn't in it. He stole a kiss as he rode away. He never hung his hat at Kitty's place. Should have been a cowboy, should have learned to rope and ride. Wearing my six shooter, riding my pony on a cattle drive. Stealing them a young girl's hearts, just like Gene and Roy, singing those campfire songs. Man, I should have been a cowboy. I might have had a sidekick with a funny name, running wild through the hills chasing Jesse James, ending up on the brink of danger, riding shotgun the Texas Ranger. Go west, young man, haven't you been told? California's full of whiskey, lots of women and gold, sleeping out all night under the desert star with a dream in my eye and a prayer. Heart. Hey, I should have been a cowboy. Should have learned to rope and ride. Wearing my six shooter, riding my pony on a cattle drive. Stealing them a young girl's hearts. All just like Gene and Roy, singing them campfire songs. Man, I should have been. Cowboy, should have been a cowboy. Yeah, I should have been a cowboy. Should have been a cowboy. Should have been a cowboy. One of my favorites. Hey guys, let's just pop in the chat. Let's take it all the way up and see what's going on in the Mulberry Studio. Say hi to Pete and Julie. Hey Pete and Julie. Oh, Looks, I don't know if being a cowboy is a good thing. It looks like a little rustling going on up there. Oh, Pete, you look captive, like a prisoner or something out there. Thanks, guy. I tell you what, you should have been a cowboy. I don't know. It sounds like being a cowboy, you get tied up or something, maybe. What do you think about that, Renee? She said family show.
No comment.
Probably a good call. Thanks, Pete and Julie. Hey, guys, it's that time of the show. It's that time of the show where we're going to share some show picks, and then I'm going to sing a song, and then you want to stick around because it's drawing time. We ask that you check in, let us know what city you're watching from, and then we ask if you would share this video, and if you share the video and type I shared in the chat, you're eligible to win a free prize off of me. So after we go through the show picks and I sing the next song, we're going to draw the winner from last week's shares. Is that clear as mud? Julie's going to go through all the directions here at the end of the next song. But before we do that, let's go to some show picks from last week. And I don't know if it's been a crazy day. I don't know if I got to everything I wanted to today. Let's see if I did. Well, it looks like I did. We started out Thursday night at the locale in Brownsburg. We do this show each and every Thursday night. So I hope you guys continue coming. And if you're a newbie out there, make sure and get you some reservations and come on out to the locale in Brownsburg. Of course, our friends Lisa Carolyn and Debbie were there sitting on the front row, and they were, the thing about these girls, they were singing. When I played Call Me When You Need Me, Love Me When You Want To, they were singing every word of that song. That's unbelievable. Lisa, Carolyn, Debbie, thank you so much for coming out. I appreciate it. Right up on the front row singing with me. I love it when people sing my own songs to me. And then let's see. Oh, there's the girls. There's the girl. There's Tammy, our newbie friend, Julian, Jenny, and Tanya. Thank you, ladies, for making the show. They're always right up front, distracting the entertainer and everybody else in the joint. There's our good friends, Mindy and DJ, and Susan right up there on the front row. Thank you guys for coming out. Mindy and DJ always help me. They're just like Pete and Dance and Larry and all you others that help out at my live stream shows whenever I'm my live performances. Mindy was holding the door looking pretty and directing traffic, and DJ's hauling all the heavy stuff. Thank you guys for helping out. Susan, always a pleasure seeing you at a show. And then, of course, when you get in to Hendricks County, Vicky and Peggy are always there. Always being. Doesn't Peggy look a little mischievous? I think those two together are mischievous. I love you, Peggy and Vicky, but you girls are mischievous. You're mischievous. I know that. And look at here. Speaking of mischievous girls, look, I got lassoed just like Pete did. Vivian's got a hold on. You really got a hold on me. Vivian's with me, Sam. And that is Pam on the front row up there. Carolyn and Sandy. I got them all in. I tell you, it took me a while to remember all those names. Mm-hmm. But I got them. Thank you, ladies, for coming out and making Thursday night so much fun. There's our new friend, Kimberly, out there. Kimberly, thanks for making the John Stevens Show. Hope to see you again. We met Kimberly and Avon at Whiskey Bent a long, long time ago. And she made it up. Here's two of my favorites. And Buzz and Betty, thank you so much. You know, they were asking me about how mom's getting along. And I told her, how she's doing, getting along really good. And Buzz goes, John, he goes, now, we like coming to listen to your music, but we like being your friend. We care about you. And we like to know what's going on. And I get that from so many of my people out there that come to the shows. I appreciate you, but I'm glad we're good friends, Bad Betty and Buzz, and so many others, just like Brendan, Brene, and Pete, and Julian. I hate to start naming names because I'd be leaving people out, but we appreciate all of you that are more than just fans out there. We appreciate you. And there, of course, Tanya, she's got to be in everything, dude. Tanya, she's got another picture, Tanya and Tammy, but they're pretty girls, so we'll put them up there. And then there was Dovey and Kat sitting up the front. Kat goes, I haven't been to a John Stevens show forever. I really had a good time tonight. Well, yeah, we have a good time at the local, Kat. Hope to see you more often. And my girl Dovey over there, I always call her my girl. She likes that. She drinks PBR, and they didn't have any PBR. Oh, yeah, she loves PBR big time, don't you, Dovey? Good stuff. And speaking of good friends, there's Sarah on the front row and Larry and Loretta. They are so true blue. They come to every time I'm virtually there, except for the last time because they had to go to Beef and Boards, but it's okay. But thank you guys for your friendship and loyalty. And then there's Jenny up there. Had to get a picture with Jenny. Jenny, thank you for being a new follower and a new fan at the local John Stevens Jr. show. And speaking of fans, check this guy out. Mr. Nichols. Mark, good to see you out there. Now he is synonymous with the word mischievous.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, I got references on that. So, and then Friday night, we were in Lebanon at that sports bar. And let me tell you, it was hot and it was humid. But we had a good show. Let's see who all we had there. Oh, yeah, my classmate Michelle was there, and Brenda were there. Thank you, ladies, for coming out. Sitting right up on the front row. We bantered back and forth all night long, along with some of the regulars. Brene and Brenda were up there on the front row, too. So thank you, Michelle and Brenda, for making the show. And Serena and VTR and the rest of the gang, thank you all for making it there. It's always great to see a lot of familiar faces and friends on a Friday night in Lebanon. And there's Joe and Deborah. Now, Joe has done this twice. I said, Joe, do something special for me. And I don't know how this happens, Joe. We're going to make sure we get it next time. Both times, they went to video. I don't know what, when he goes to give Deborah a kiss. Mm-hmm. It's went to video twice. I don't know whether I get nervous. And I don't know what happens. We'll get it right next time. But Joe and Deborah, because, you know, it's like, you always take our picture of us just hanging on each other because we like each other. I said, do something special. And he's tried. He's tried, but... Operator, what's that?
They're getting married.
No.
Yes.
Uh-huh. They're getting married? How come nobody told me? Is that a secret?
No. No.
Not anymore. Yeah, we just Friday. We announced it on the John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday live stream, but I guess it's old news. Hey, you all say congratulations to Joe and Deborah out there. They're getting married. Awesome. Awesome. And there's Dean and Tammy. Tammy Tony's always in the chat with us. There's Dean, there's Ashley, and Tammy, and there's James up there. Thank you. Speaking of PBR, he's got his PBR shirt on there. Debbie'd like to have that. I know she would. And then speaking of regular crew, there they are, right up on the front row. There's Brene right there in the center, smiling at me. He's like, John, hurry up and take the picture. I want to get back to my cocktail. Julie's there, and Pete was there. And Brenda sitting at the head of the table, and the sheriff and Big T. Thank you guys for coming out and staying all night long through the heat. It was a hot one. And then Chris Ann was there. She loved that picture. But Chris Ann, it was either a picture with your eyes like that or a picture with my eyes like that. So guess what's going on? When you're the executive producer, it's all about me. So anyway, guys, thank you so much. We want you guys to come to a John Stevens Jr. show. We will try to get your pictures out there. Saturday night, I had the night off. Good thing, because I had a little tummy issues going on. But then on Sunday, I played at the Moose Family Picnic outside, and it was hot, and I was still kind of fighting my gremlins a little bit. So I didn't get any pictures from Sunday, but we had a great time. And a lot of the Moose family was there, and friends from Crawfordsville. Just a great afternoon of good food and fellowship and good music and songs. All right, with that being said, we're going to talk about, you know what I didn't do? Where did I not put them? Did I not put them? Yes, I did. Yeah, I did. Where am I going to be this week, right? They were saying, John, where are you playing this week? Well, Thursday night, we're headed down to JR's Bar again in Jasper. We've been doing this show for 6.5 years, every other Thursday night. Be back there again one more week, this particular Thursday night. And then on Friday, I want to let you guys know, there's our buddy Rick Ledoon, who popped into the chat a while ago. If you see Rick, say hi to him again. Chris Wolf and myself, we're going to be at Rainwater Studios doing a live stream show. The first hour is free. Now, I put the event, I want to say two things here. Number one, make sure you are following the John Stevens Jr. Music Facebook page. Okay, a lot of you follow me on my John Stevens page, but this video doesn't show here. Tonight doesn't either. It's on the John Stevens Jr. Music page. If you're on the music page, you'll get notifications about our Monday night. This particular show, I don't know whether you'll get a notification or not. So make sure and go to the John Stevens Jr. Music page, 8:00. On Friday night, and we'll be doing a live stream show down in Brown County with Keenan Rainwater down at Rainwater Studios. The first hour is going to be free, and there will be links inside the event that's on my page for Facebook or YouTube, however you'd like to prefer to watch it. The second hour is paid, so you have to pay to catch that. But hope you all will join me Monday. Jump in the chat. I would love to see a lot of John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday fans jump into that live stream. It is on my music page. Look for that event, and it'll be at the top of the page Friday night, and all you'll have to do at 8:00 is click on it, and the link will be there, and you'll be able to watch the show. Jump in the chat and say hi if you don't have plans on Friday. We'll be able to see the chat in the studio where we're performing, and we'd love to say hi to you guys. And while you guys are out there, put in the chat tonight, would you guys let me, what would you like me to play? I'm not sure how many songs we're going to get to do, all right? But let me know what songs that you would like me to play on Friday night. If you got a couple request songs you'd like me to play, put them in the chat for me, and I would appreciate that. All right, well, you guys are doing that. I should look in the chat real quick, see what's going on, because I haven't been to you. Chris Smith's out there. Sandy's out there. Good to see you. My goodness. Mark Schmidt, good to see you. Hey, he's already shared. Mr. Schmidt, hope to see you on Thursday night down in Jasper. Hey, there's Barb Dubar back with. Hi, Barb. How are you doing? Hey, we need to swing by and see how Barb's doing. All right. Good to see you out there, Barb. Cindy, Vicky, Doppert, thank you. Faye Cole. And I think it's Aunt Teresa's out there. Good to see you, Aunt Teresa. Rita Dennis. I'm seeing some new Kathy Van Cleve. I'm looking for newbies out there. There's our buddy Rick Ledoon out there. Y'all go say hi to Rick, all right? Go check out his page on Facebook and make sure to say hi to him and say, hey, I saw you Monday night in the John Stevens Made It Through Monday live stream. Thanks for joining us, Rick. Chris Smith. All right, my mama's out there. I think I got about it. Lena Mings has joined us. Tracy Livingston. What's she? She's checking in from her back porch on the south side of Indy playing Yahtzee. See, they're multitasking too. Very good. Yahtzee. That's not, I haven't played Yahtzee forever. That is awesome. The Traveling DeArmonds, Julie pulled up for us out there. They're finally back in town. Hope you guys can make the quarter bar next time we see you. Larry White from Pressway. Good to see you, Larry and Karen. Glad to have you with us. All right, guys, let's get on to the next song. Make sure, and if you guys have some questions for me, leave them in the chat. I read each and every comment. I respond to each and every comment by letting you know with a like or a love or a care. And if there's a question for me or you address me, I'll respond to each and every one of them. So make sure and send all your comments out there. I would love to respond to them. I'd love to get to know you better. If you're a new person for the first time, make sure and say hi. I would love to get to know you out there. All right, we got a song off my new album, my latest album. It's not new, it's a year old now. But for any of you people ever been day drinking and needed to get an Uber, this song is for you. It's called Uber Me Home. Oh, remind me after this song. I got one more announcement before I toss it to June. Will you remind me, Brene? This is a test. I started day drinking in the morning, then I blew right past noon. Next thing I was knowing, it was late afternoon. All the girls are looking pretty, my funds are getting low. My common sense was screaming, it was way past time to go. I tossed my phone on top of the bar along with my keys. I said, bartender, could you help me? A Texas message, please. Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me home. Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me. I got that Uber app on my phone. Hey, I could probably drive her home by closing one that eye, but I'd be better off in the backseat watching my Uber driver drive. It's fun to watch this song to people who've never heard it. Next time they start doing that little Uber dance themselves. Yeah, they do. But then that music started playing and I felt something in my feet. So I jumped up off the stool and grabbed that girl right next to me. We were swinging, getting our groove on, pretending we knew all the words to every single song. Hey, I tangled up my feet and crashing to the floor. That was my final clue. I didn't need to drink no more. Somebody Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me home. Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me. I've got that Uber app on my phone. Hey, I could probably drive her home by closing one bad eye, but I'd be better off backseat watching my Uber driver drive. Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me. We're on the outro. Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me home. One more pass. Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me, Uber me home. She did remember. She had, see, I was saying, did she remember? She did. Hey, I forgot to tell you. Originally, we had a show scheduled for this Saturday at 9 East, and I got a text this afternoon, and they said, John, it's absolutely my fault. But when I said we were going to book you for August the 19th, I wrote in my calendar August 18th. And, of course, we're going to be at... Thank you. I'd have found it. It just takes a while. You'll get old one of these days. You'll get old one of these days. At Rainwater. And it happens. You know, I've done that so many times myself. So I hate that I'm not going to be there. But Kara, I saw you out there in the chat. I know that we were planning on looking forward to seeing you and maybe some of the other Rochdale and Putnam County friends. But that show will not be happening Saturday night. So, hey, Right now, I'm open Saturday as we speak. I'm not sure what's going to happen, but if you guys want to put together a private party, give me a call. We'll get something going. Anyway, no show Saturday at 9 East Barger. Hopefully, we'll get rescheduled one of these days and get back there. So, wanted to make sure and get that clear before I toss it to Julie, because it's drawing time. Julie and Pete are joining us in the Mulberry Studio. And Julie, take it away.
Hi, everybody. Hope you all had a good day, even though it was kind of gloomy and rainy. As you can see, I let the cowboy go. It's a little tough to do drawing when he's all tied up in a lasso. So for any newbies out there, if you would like to have a chance at winning some merchandise on John, all you need to do is share John's video. You can share it now. You can share it when it's over. Just make sure you type "I shared" into the chat, and we will go back and write down your names, and we'll put them in the hopper, and you might have a chance to win some merchandise. I'm going to run the shares. Those are all the people who did share Don's video and typed "I shared" from last week, and they got their names in. So Pete's going to go ahead and twirl the hopper, and we're going to find out who won a Made It Through Monday mug on John this week. Now, if you win, make sure that you look at your instant messenger, because I will be asking what color mug you would like and where you want it sent it to. All right, let's see who this Monday's winner is. Ah, Larry White, you are this week's winner of the Made It Through Monday mug. So make sure that you watch your instant messenger, because I will be contacting you. Everybody say congrats to Larry. All right, John, back to you.
Hey, thanks, Julie. I appreciate that. Thanks for you and Pete. I'm glad you let Pete go. I tell you, I was a little bit worried about that, but I don't know whether... I figured Pete was probably... He could have broke loose if he needed to be. You think so?
Yeah.
I think he was played along nicely. Thanks, Pete. Thanks, Julie. Appreciate that. Guys, we're going to do one more song. Thank you. Make sure and check in. Make sure and hit the like and love button up there. Make sure that you share this video with your friends. Tag a friend. Share it in your groups. We appreciate your support out there. Make sure you're following the John Stevens Jr. Music Facebook page, and that way you'll get a notice when I go live each and every week. Don't forget, Friday night, we would love to see you in the live stream show, at least the first hour. But thank you guys for joining us again. I appreciate each and every one of you who take your time to be with me. Thank you, Brene and Brenda, for letting me come over here to the Lebanon Kitchen Studios. I like it. It's kind of homey here. So thank you guys for letting me come in and do our live stream here. And thank you guys again for joining us this week. Good Lord will and the creek don't rise. We will see you next Monday. But before we get out here, here's a song. This is Three Chords in the Truth, a little tune I wrote called "For the First Time in a Long Time." For the first time in a long time, you looked at me, and I saw that shine glowing in your eyes like I used to see. Your pretty smile broke for a little while, but it's been hard to find. It gave my heart some hope for the first time in a long time. First time in a long time, you reached for my hand, and I felt the hurt from all those angry words we both said. Like a lullaby soothes a baby's cry, you calmed my fears inside. I wasn't scared for us for the first time in a long time. Second chances don't come every day. not let this one slip away. For the first time in a long time, you wrapped your arms round me and you laid your head upon my chest. So tight, just like old times, my heart jumped inside. Oh, you took my breath away for the first time in a long time. Time in a long time, I tasted your sweet lips like warm red wine makes all the world right. You made mine with one kiss, and you took my hands, and we began to dance in the hallway light. Felt like you loved me again for the first time in a long time. Oh, I know you guys love to do your little slow dancing. I love playing that song for you. You know, when I was just thinking when I started to put the pieces together, I thought, you know, I kind of thought you looked at me. I was kind of going, but in the back of my mind, I'm thinking scenario, you know, I got to be making love at some point, you know, for the first time in a long time. And I thought, no, we'll just keep it sweet, you know. It's just, they danced together and he got a kiss. That's as far as it needed to go. That's as far as it needed to go. That's as far as we've got to go tonight for another John Stevens Jr. Made It Through Monday live stream. Thank you guys for joining me. Send me your request out there. Let me know where you're watching from. Check in. Say hi to everybody. Congratulations to Larry White. See you in Jasper on Thursday. See you in the live stream at Rainwater Studio on the John Stevens Jr. Music page Friday night at 8 p.m. for those of you that are home and watching. And make sure, I would love to see our Made It Through Monday crew jump in the chat and just send all kinds of questions and say hi and make requests out there. Let me know what you, again, let me know what songs you'd like me to play Friday night in this live stream show. With that said, you know what time it is, Brene? Yeah. Brenda? That's right. Say goodnight, John Boy. Turn out the lights. Party's over. They say it all. Good things won't stand. Turn out the lights. Party's over. We'll see you down the road next Monday night, 7:30 p.m. Eastern time, and we'll do it all. Say goodnight, John Boy. Thank you guys for joining me. I'm going to hang out in the chat just for a little bit and say hello to you. You guys have done a great job. Gary Figg, I see you out there. Good to see you. Bob Vitro. Ruth Ann Carpenter, thanks for joining us. Family in the house tonight. Lena Mings in Crawfordsville. We said hi to Becky and Faye. And Larry White, thank you, buddy. Congratulations. Now, tell Karen she's going to have to share if she wants to use your cup, because you got a free Made It Through Monday live stream. Glad to have you guys with us. Appreciate it. Hi, Gary Figg. Mike Westerfield out there. Hey, there's Mary. Mary, thank you for joining us. I appreciate that. Good to see you, Don Brown in Crawfordsville. Thanks for joining us. I appreciate that. Scotty, what the heck? John Boy, nice to see you again. Welcome back Monday night. We are glad to have you back with us, Scotty. Hope Mary's been out there with you too. We've missed you guys. We've missed you. It's been a while. There's my mama. Thanks for helping me write the Heavenly Opera, Mama. Y'all say hi to my mama out there. And Karen McGill, thank you so much. I was looking forward to hopefully seeing you on Saturday night. It's not going to work out this month. Maybe we'll get rescheduled and get that worked in real soon. All right. I'm seeing Bob Cruz. Going to see you here in a couple days. And I think that's everybody, Betty. Good to see him. I'm going to let you guys go. Becky Cummins is out there. Aunt Teresa. And Rick is all right. Look at it. He's in. Congratulations to Mr. Larry out there. Appreciate you guys. All right. I'm going to jump out of here. You guys have a great Monday night. What's left of it. And we'll see you next week. Take care.